Hi, I'm John. Welcome to this Math Minute. Today I'd like to talk about math anxiety. It's very common for adults and children in our society to fear math or even hate the subject. Many people think you need to be born with a gift to do well in math, and that it's inherently hard and beyond the grasp of most people. Because I struggled in math when I was young, I sometimes feel anxious when I have to solve a problem in front of people, even though I'm a mathematician now. Unfortunately, the problem is circular because it's very easy for an adult to pass on their attitude or their anxiety around math to a child. Research suggests, for example, that if a parent tells their child they were once bad at math, the child's marks tend to decline immediately. And it's very easy for a teacher to pass on their anxiety to their students. Fortunately, there are things we can do to address this problem. We can give teachers the support they need to feel they're good at doing and teaching math, and we can give them access to evidence-based resources that help every child learn math. We could also give teachers access to confidence-building exercises that have been designed to make every student feel that it's fun to solve problems and that they can meet any challenge. For example, I once had an opportunity to teach some high school students who were struggling at school and who had some behavioral issues. Some of them had even been suspended. So I decided I would teach them how to subtract big numbers. You might think it's hard to subtract a number from a million because there's so many zeros. You might think you have to do a lot of regrouping, but there's a way you can do this mentally. And when the kids saw they could do these big calculations in their heads, I couldn't believe how excited they got and how engaged they got. So here's how you could subtract a number from a million in your head. Instead of using the number a million, use the number 999,999. Use a number that's one less than a million that has all nines. It's easy to subtract a number from a number that only has nines in it because there's no regrouping involved. However, your answer is one too low because you've subtracted the number from 999,999, which is one less than a million. So to get the correct answer, you just have to add one to your answer, and then you've subtracted the number from a million. Imagine what the world would look like if we could dispel math anxiety so that all children could not only learn math, but love learning math. As adults who know how to solve complex problems, they could work together productively to tackle the most challenging problems we face today. Yeah. I hope you've enjoyed this Math Minute. I'll see you next time.